Good morning, students. Today we will do the extra questions of poem 2 An Elementary School Classroom in a Slum. Okay, as we all know that the poet Stephen Spender is quite disappointed because of the social injustice and class inequalities, and therefore he has written this poem, An Elementary School Classroom in a Slum, and he wants that slum children should also get the equal opportunities as the city people. Okay, so let us go with the question answers. What changes does the poet hope for in the lives of slum children? Means what sort of changes poet want that in the life of slum children should be there? So let us see the answer. The poet wishes education for the slum children, means in the name of education they are having a school, but the quality education is not provided to them. Therefore he want that a proper education must be given to these children, which will broaden their horizons, okay, so that they can think related to their progress, they can progress in real sense and liberate them truly and empower them to create their own history. Okay, so that they can make big changes in their lives and they can create their own history. He wants them to get rid of their dismal lives. Means they should get the opportunities to come out of their slums, and from that pathetic life they should live a better life. That poet wants this type of changes the poet wants in the life of the slum children. Okay, let us move towards the second question. What message does Stephen Spender convey through the poem An Elementary School Classroom in a Slum? This is the name of the poem. So what message does the poet wants to convey? The message that Stephen Spender convey through the poem is that all the teachers, inspectors, visitors and other educators should together do something to improve the lot of the slum children. Means all these important people of the society must do something to improve the life of slum children. Means their way of living must change with the effort of these important people of the society, who will otherwise remain in the pathetic state of poverty and deprivation. Okay, so this is the second question. Okay, let us move towards the third question. In spite of despair and disease pervading the lives of the slum children, they are not devoid of hope. How far do you agree? Means they are living a very pathetic life, then also they are having some hope in their life. Do you agree with this? The question arises here. So here you can give the answer in yes, means in the positive manner, or in the negative manner. But the basic thing is you have to justify your answer. Means if you say yes, then you have to justify that why you are saying yes. Or if you say no, then again you have to justify that why they don't have any hope. Okay. So let us see the answer to this question. Despite the disease and despair pervading the lives of the slum children, they are still hopeful. There is a sweet little boy, means they are hopeful, means in the positive manner. The answer has been written here. And we are justifying it by these things, that a sweet little boy who has dreams in his eyes and is looking out at the playful squirrel. Okay, this we have seen in the first paragraph of the poem, and the poet too feels that one day these children will be truly liberated. Means poet too is hopeful that if by the efforts of teachers, educators, inspectors, politicians, these children will definitely come out of their despair, dismal lives, and they will live a free life, they will create their own history. So therefore these children's life is full of hope. Okay, now let us see the question number 4. The poet says, and yet for these children, these windows, not this map, their world, which world do these children belong to? Means here these windows, not this map, So which map, about which map the poet has asked, has discussed up here. So which world is inaccessible to them? We all know that the world which really the city people are living, for these slum children, it is inaccessible. Inaccessible means which is very far to reach or which where is impossible to reach, okay? These children belong to a world of foggy slums, dark and narrow lanes, leading a poor and miserable life. This we all know. And the world inaccessible to them is the civilized world with all its riches and beautiful things. Okay, means there is a lot of difference between the slum life and the civilized city life. Okay, so these miserable life are the real world of slum children, and inaccessible world to them is the civilized life of the city. Okay, now let us see the sixth question. How does the poet describe the classroom walls? Means what sort of classroom walls are there discussed in the poem? The poet describes classroom walls as having the color of sour cream. Sour cream means faded, colorless, or with a bad smell also. They are decorated with the pictures of Shakespeare, building with domes, world maps, and beautiful valleys. Okay, means the walls are quite dirty, but they are being decorated with these pictures. Along with this, these things, the picture, the name of donations also mentioned on the walls. Okay, so this was the fifth question. Let us read the last question. So bold their maps with slums as big as dome, says Stephen Spender. What does the poet want to convey? Means why these lines are being written in the poem by Stephen Spender. So let us read the answer. The poet wants to convey that the future of these children is bleak. Bleak means that is uncertain. It is blotted by fog and spells doom for them. He hopes that one day these maps would become their window. Means one day they will come out in the real world, means real map, and they will find a space for them there, and they will live a happy and satisfactory life. Okay, so this is all the poem, students. Now in the next video we will begin with the next chapter, that is the Tiger King. Thank you.